Hello, I'm Graham Horton and welcome to today's video, which is the result of a question posed by a subscriber to this channel. And the question was, would the FZ80-82 camera be a better camera than the FZ300-330 when you want to capture long focus shots? So with the FZ80-82, you know you've got the x60 lens, which gives you a 1200mm effective focal length. The FZ300-330 has just a 600mm effective focal length. But the question was, if you used i.Zoom with that 600mm, would the 1200mm that you get by multiplying the i.Zoom factor of times 2 with the optical, you get 1200, would that quality be better than the FZ80-82? Now, the answer to that is in several parts. Basically, the FZ80-82 has an 18 megapixel sensor, where the FZ300-330 has a 12 megapixel sensor. So the FZ80-82 has really a third more pixels to the same unit area of sensor. So if the lens can resolve that amount of detail, the FZ80-82 shot should have more fine detail. But because of the smaller pixel size, you get the downside effect there of noise at lower light levels. If you're working in reasonable bright light, then the FZ80-82 can actually give better images than the FZ300-330. Once the light levels start to drop, then you're at a disadvantage with the FZ80-82 because the way the lens works, the aperture is f5.9 when you're at that 1200mm focal length. Conversely, if you look at the FZ300-330, it's a constant aperture lens, so if you set it at f2.8, even when you're at 600mm, you're still at f2.8. That's got two more stops worth of light over the FZ80-82, which is four times the amount of light. So you're getting a lot more light onto that sensor, which means you can use faster shutter speeds if you need to for sport or wildlife, or you can have a lower ISO and have noise-free images. So what happens with i.Zoom when you reach the full limit of the optical? It means that you start to crop into the area of the sensor. And if you go into times 2, then you're actually using just 1/4 of the image. You then expand that or extrapolate it back to the original image size. So if we're using 4000 by 3000 as the image size, once you crop into that to 1920 by 1080, which will be the 2x i.Zoom, you then expand that back out to 4000 by 3000. So you are losing some detail by extrapolation, but the results in some circumstances are quite good. Up to times 1.4 or times 1.7, it's worth using i.Zoom in preference to an optical extender. I tested this several times with different makes of afocal teleconverters, and times 1.4 gives a better result than using the lens attached to the camera. Probably depends on the manufacturing of the lens, but in my test, the afocal teleconverter gave a worse image than using times 1.4 i.Zoom. So in my test today, I've been out with the FZ80-82 and shot at 1200mm or the x60, and then used the x600 on the FZ300-330 and used x2 i.Zoom to produce a JPEG image which has an equivalent focal length of 1200mm. In some situations, the FZ80 clearly outshines the FZ300-330, but once light levels started to fall, you notice much more image noise on the FZ80-82, and the FZ300 beat it in that situation. Remember, when you're producing a i.Zoom image, it's JPEG only. You can't use RAW and JPEG to produce the i.Zoom. It only works in a JPEG mode. So the camera will produce a RAW file, crop into it, and then extrapolate it back to the full image size and produce a JPEG image from it. Now, some people say it's better to produce the JPEG image and then crop into it to give you the expansion that you want. Unfortunately, that doesn't work because the camera's already processed that image. It's converted the 10-bit RAW file within the camera to an 8-bit JPEG, so you've lost some tonal gradation there, and you've got also JPEG artifacts. So if you try to crop into that and magnify it, you'll see even more JPEG artifacts. The fact that you're going to save the image again, you're saving a JPEG image from a JPEG image, and again, you add in more artifacts. My preferred way of working is to take the RAW file, convert it to a 16-bit TIFF, which is by default the way that the RAW converter works, then crop in to 1920 by 1080 if you want 10x2 zoom, do your sharpening, do your noise reduction, do all the processing you need to do that file, If necessary, you can put that file into Photoshop and use extrapolation to produce again that 4000 by 3000 image with a fairly good image quality. But you can actually use this with larger format sensors, so you can use it with Micro Four Thirds or APS-C, shoot in RAW, expand to 16-bit TIFF, crop into what you want, do your sharpening and noise reduction, etc., and then extrapolate it if you want the larger size image for prints, etc. You'll find you get much better images. Well, that's it for the video. I do hope you found that useful. If you're a new viewer, why not hit that subscribe button and the bell notification icon to be advised when I upload new videos to the channel. And if you've not already seen my photographic blog, why not to have a look at that? I'll put a link to that in the video description below. Lots more information on Panasonic Lumix bridge cameras, Canon EOS M range, and on some of the Micro Four Thirds system cameras. So until the next video, thanks again for watching. Please do comment on the images in the video above and see what you think about them. So until then, thanks very much for watching. Please do take care, and I hope to see you all very, very soon. Goodbye for now.